So what I'm trying to attempt here is to take out the intermediate shaft, which connects the steering wheel to the steering box. It's this shaft, because my wheel is misaligned. So the wheels are aligned, but the steering wheel is not aligned. So what I'm going to do is take it out, then hopefully click it one spline over, and that will make the steering wheel sit flush again. So now when I'm driving, it's not like this, but like this. And I don't really like that. It needs to be level. So let's dive in. So first I need to take out this one, which is rather easy. I already loosened it up. So hopefully this will just... Yep. And I have to take off this one. And then there's another bolt down here, which is probably hard to see, but you've got to believe me. So this bolt is out, that bolt is out. So according to instructions, I should now just be able to take it out. This part should be collapsible. However, when I put any tension on here, it doesn't slide. So probably that's rusted or at least shut over the last, was it 29 years of age. So probably I have to spray it again with some let loose juice. So this is usually the stuff I go to. So let me spray some on here, let it sit for a while, then hopefully this will slide onto this and will give me the leverage to shorten the shaft and then take it out. So it has been sitting for a while now, so hopefully when I apply some pressure here, yay, there's movement. You can see it here, it does slide in, so that's very, very good. So before this one slips off, I'm going to center the wheel, center the hub down here, then click it one over, put it back on, and then see how the alignment is. So a while back I bought this universal joint from Flaming River, but it was for a different steering box, so hopefully this will fit. I fear not. I think this one is actually too big. Yep, it is. So that sucks. So this double D I think is actually the right size, so this should fit in here. Yep, so that one is too big, which sucks. Because I bought this specially in the States for a lot of doll hairs. So probably I have to buy a new one. I will send an email to Flaming River to ask them if only this part can be exchanged, because this one is okay. So then I only need half of the thing. Then again, looking at this, I have no clue how to get it apart. But of course, the benefit of this one over the rack joint, which is this one, there's some play and some flex in it. It's not that bad, but this is just much more beefy and solid. And yeah, let's be honest, it looks a lot better too. So this one unfortunately is too big, so I need something that that fits on there. This is, I believe, a, what's it, 36 spline. That one is less. So I have to count the splines and see how they line up. Then again, stating this, I just said I'm loosening this up to re-clock the shaft, but there's a flat spot here, so that has no sense. So I cannot just click it one over. So I need to come up with another solution. I think the same goes for the steering wheel, that can also not be re-clocked. So the only solution I then have is to get a realignment, and then the shafts, I don't know how they're called, stuurstangen, they need to be lengthened on one side and shortened on the other side in order to correct the steering wheel. So yeah, small project. Unfortunately, it doesn't really work as I would like it to work, which is a pity. Then again, another thing learned, so I will reinstall the intermediate shaft, or whatever it was called, intermediate shaft, and take it from there. And while we're at it, I'm just beautify it a little bit. So already spray painted this with this really nice industrial flat black aerosol, and also flash this one, so it's now currently drying above my heating panel. It's part of the central heating of the house, centrale verwarming. So that will clear up, or actually flatten, probably in the next couple of minutes. Then will look like this. So I'll give it half an hour, take some lunch, and maybe flash it again. I think this is should be sufficient. Of course, it serves no purpose functionally, it's just for beautifying things. So I didn't spray this part because that's the shaft that goes in here, so it will be scratched up again anyway. So just the metal parts that are exposed will be nice and pretty and flat black again. So this is now painted. Let's slide them together. Hopefully that work as expected. Okay. So far so good. Sprinting. Okay, that should work. Now let's mount it up, and not really starting to scratch, but what do you do? To be continued down below. Well, that wraps it up for this small intermediate episode. So as we can see, it's let me bring in the light. Pretty much left off where I started. So in order to clock the steering wheel, I needed to change one, or click it one spline. However, that didn't work, unfortunately. There's no adjustability here. So all I ended up with in, what is it, like a couple of hours later, is a spray painted intermediate shaft, and that's about it. So that kind of sucks. It's a waste of time, but I'll figure out something out to get it aligned again. So probably I will end up adjusting these, and also at the other end, so to push this one slightly out and that one slightly inwards. Yeah, that will then hopefully end up with a straight steering wheel. Thank you very much for watching. Leave a like if you want to, subscribe if you like to, and see you on the next one. Take care. Bye bye. Toodaloo.